All right, y'all. I told y'all I wasn't playing, man. I told y'all I wasn't playing about this year. And we're going in full effect. Full bam yams. Thank you, ma'am. And today we're giving you guys the initial thoughts, review, whatever you want to. First mag. I don't know what I'm going to title this yet, but I'm pretty much breaking it down on the recent pickup of the Springfield Armory Hellion. So you see it, man, Springfield Armory Hellion, which is the civilian version of the VHS-2, one of the my favorite guns of all time. You know, some people call it, you know, the FAMAS from Call of Duty. It's out here, man. It's in full effect in a civilian version. And this is a bullpup, which pretty much is a 16-inch carbine, but the difference than a regular, you know, rifle with bullpup is the whole chambering, the whole action goes on back here, you know, in the shoulder. And a lot of that, you know, allows this gun to be overall have a 16-inch barrel because of how far it is within here, and then allowing you to have a stock. And this is not a pistol, this is a carbine. This is an overall, I believe, of like 26.5 inches overall, so it meets the requirements of the overall length for it to be a rifle as well. And this gun itself is shorter than many like of my other pistol configurations out there. So the bullpup type of format in a gun is definitely an advantage of having a gun that is very small, compact, but massive as far as capabilities, distances, and all the above. And we have here today, of course, as I stated, the Springfield Armory Hellion. And this is a very brand new, you know, gun over here on the civilian side of things when it comes to the bullpups. You know, we have the AUGs, we have the Tavors, we've had the DMRs, and now we have brought to the table the Hellion. And, you know, I was on the fence, and even, my bad, Kel-Tec as well. I was on the fence, you know, trying to figure out which bullpup I actually wanted. I want to go with something classic like the AUG, which, hey, maybe down the road I might grab it. I like the Tavor as well, but I know Bull really liked the you know, he loved the Tavor. So I was like, I'm going to let Bull get that Tavor before I go and interrupt anything. And I loved the VHS, the FAMAS, the look. Always liked it. Always loved it. When I saw this gun first come out, I was like, damn, I really, really want to get my hands on that. And that's before I even started doing, like, reviews and stuff like that. Well, I eventually got it, and now we here are, you know, we're today, we got it. The difference, and one of the big things about when it comes to bullpups compared to your regular rifles, is just the ergonomics overall. A lot of things are different. You know, the charging handle is back in the front, when, you know, typical ARs, it's back down here, and then your mag is usually right here, and your trigger's back here, but now it's like pretty much flipped around. Your grip right here, with your magazine back there. So it's a lot of differences when it goes into having a bullpup. I decided to outfit this though with this is a Strike Industries, almost like a very stubby hand stop, because I don't need it like that. I don't want to shoot it like this. I want to shoot it like this. This is the type of grip I have on the gun. I wrap my thumb over the top and I like to sit on it just like that. Overall, I hold like this, and I like to have the stock all the way collapsed. You have a very, very long, you know, length of pull going on here. And this is on the shortest, you know, stock setting. You can, hold on, go all the way out even more, but that's just insane, you know. But overall, let's talk about the cons, because there's not that many. So I want to go ahead and get that out the way, and then we'll go from tit to butt as well as what I, you know, decided to go with on this gun and why, because I have shot it. Cons, I want to say there's only two, and the first one I'm gonna go ahead and get out the way. It's the one I hate the most. This thing, out of all the guns I own, this gun has the worst trigger ever. I hate the damn trigger on this gun. It's horrible. It's horrible in my opinion. It's too much mush to the point where I'm shooting it and I'm thinking the reset is gonna happen, and I go to shoot again and it doesn't happen. Like, the reset and the mush is insane. Let me show you. So we're gonna take the mag out. Look at this. Y'all ready? Look at all that take up. That's all the take up. So you got to go all the way here, and then, now watch the reset. Nope, there's the reset. So the reset is past, when you get the reset, you still got to have more take up when you shoot it again. You get what I'm saying? Usually when I shoot a gun, when I shoot it, and say the reset's right there, it hits the reset, that means if I hit this again, it's gone. You know, it's going to shoot it again. But no, the reset, where they set the reset of the trigger, is past that. That is still take up. I mean, my terminology is not the best, but I know what I'm trying to say, and I know I don't deal with this on other guns. I'll even show it to you, but look, here you go. Take up, wall, right? Pressure. Still take, I'm still pushing it. You see me, you can see me pushing it. There it goes. Now watch this. I'm gonna try my best to stop that thing immediately on the reset. You'll hear it though. There it goes. That's the reset right there. You saw a lot, right? But watch this though. Watch when I press down. You see that? It's still like it was a little bit of mush on that. It's not usually, and I'm gonna grab something else. Let me see if I got something else that I can grab real quick. Here you go. This is my Sig Trev. It's one of my first guns ever. And you know, this is an AR platform. It's different than Bolt's Pup, so it might be, that might have a lot to do with it as well. And I even, this is like my first AR ever. But look, all right. This gun has no take up damn near on the trigger. That's it. You're there. You feel me? So push, pressure. There's the take up right there. That little push right there. Pressure. All right, hit. Reset. There it goes. And look, I'm already on the wall. It clicked and I'm on the wall. So there's no mush. There's straight just wall. Everything. With all that hate being said, because I gotta be mean a little bit because I'm gonna be so nice after that. I'm pretty sure there'll be aftermarket pieces down the road that will eliminate that. There has to be something. This thing is, I mean, it's a new platform, so all these aftermarket price, you know, things are not here yet. I'm pretty sure down the road there will be changes and things that can be added to it. So it's something I can live with. The next, I don't even remember what the next damn really my issue was. Oh, the next thing, which is really a problem with me. Y'all can clown me in the comment section, but this motherfucker's heavy. It's heavy. But Tony D, you just need a lift. I just need a lift. That's all. I just need a lift. Now, I took it to the range. You'll probably even see the clip. I was shooting a 60-round drum. I had a drum that was sitting in the closet for almost a year. The ammo in there for a year. I wanted to get rid of it. And I said, you know what? I'm going to put the 60-round drum because I wanted to see if it could fit the 60-round drum. I put that drum in there. I was shooting, boy, about 45, 50 rounds in. 30, something around 30 to 50, I was getting tired, boy. That thing was weighing heavy as a mug. And when you're actually, you know, having this gun in your hand like that, it's heavy back here. I'm pretty sure because the bolt and everything else is back here. And what I have in here right now is a smoke mag. This is a, I don't know if this is a Lancer. It is a Lancer. I like the smoke look on it. It looked nice. I mean, it could fit any real mag out there. I don't think it fits the G36 that everybody was asking about or wanted it to fit, because I think the original versions fit that, but it doesn't, you know, it doesn't fit that. Yeah, I mean, that's something I feel like over time, your boys gotta get stronger, man. You gotta get stronger, Tony. You can't complain about weight, but it is the most heaviest when you compare it to the Yog and the Tavor. This is the most heaviest. I want to say, though, I forgot lengthwise where this one comes in, if it's shorter or longer. I just cannot remember, so forgive me on that part.
Yo, guys, so I had to make a quick little edit because I noticed throughout this whole entire review that I was just so amazed with the look of the gun that I forgot to even talk about how it felt when I shot it. So I wanted to give you guys a quick little thoughts and opinions on that. Shooting the bullpup compared to a typical AR or rifle, one thing off the rip. It's not, when I say louder, it's technically like really loud. What happens, the bolt carry and all that is closer to your ears than your typical AR rifle. So it sounded a little bit more louder to me personally. The recoil, however, was less, believe it or not. Even though it was closer to the shoulder, the pushback didn't feel, the blowback didn't feel as much as a typical rifle. Maybe because of the fact that all the gas, you know, when the bullet is hit, the gas goes, hits the buffer tube and all that, and it goes, it's like, it's all that. Maybe the fact that it's all going on, like, kind of like on your chest more than like that. This to this is, there's a further distance, right? So you feel that more compared to it happening right here. It's like, so you're, I don't know, it just felt like a more tighter group. So I was able to get back on my shots better. Very flat shooting, great all the way out. That 16-inch barrel, you can tell there's definitely a difference for long range shots. And it's definitely something that I gotta get kind of used to, because holding that gun different compared to, you know, out here than the AR, where it's more like closer in, you have different types of length of pull for your arm, your muscle memory and all that. So I do feel like there is a lot that I have to get used to, but it's definitely a fun experience, a great experience, and it's a great shooting gun. Feels great in hand. Even though it's so weird ergonomically, you know, it didn't taking effect on how I was holding it. Like, I felt comfortable holding the gun. I didn't feel weird that my arm was basically where my hand on the trigger was, where my hand on a mag would be typically for an AR rifle. I felt like everything just worked out very, very well, in my opinion.
It does come with its own sights. I love that. You know, you press them and they come up. I love it. They have a little Dopplers in them where you can, you know, switch the switch it out, switch it to like different, you know, Dopplers, or I'm hopefully I'm saying it right, but you know, you can go big, small, more, you know, more CQB or whatever you're trying to do. But unfortunately right now, I'm not using my sight. I'm not using that on there right now. I ended up decking this out with the Vortex AMG UH1 Gen 2. This thing is beautiful. With the micro three times. Now, I originally put a LPVO on here, the one that I had on the SCAR. I took it off the SCAR, and then I put it on here, tried it a little bit, and I was not having fun with it. Did not have fun with the LPVO on there. It was extra heavy at the top. So I got rid of it. Not rid of it, but I put it on another gun, which you'll see down the road. And I have now I think it's the Strike Fire or Crossfire, I can't remember, on the SCAR, which I'll do an update video on that down the road. Stay tuned. I love it how it looks now, though. I end up putting this though on it. I love the holographic. I have not shot it yet with this current setup, so I'm gonna be taking it soon to the range to zero this in. It has the adjustable gas knob right there sticking at the top, which is also dope as well. So you can switch that out if you're gonna go suppress and all that. And one of the other issues, though, and it's not a big issue, it's not a con for me, but it's definitely a little difficult lighting mounts on this gun. But I found my way, and my way I think is going to be an easy way, and you can take that way and run with it. But there is M-locks on the handguard from here. What would they call it? It's 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock. These three, you see them right here, and then on the sides right here. Forgive me, my clock ain't working right now. But I wanted to, there's a Surefire, there's all these other types, but I didn't really want nothing too bulky. I wanted something that was good that I can actually run my hand still and do my thing right here, but also still actuate the light. And I seen a setup on Reddit, salute to the homie, I don't remember his name, but it was this one in particular. And this is the TLR RM2 laser, which I forgot. I didn't even remember this has a damn laser on it. Let me see, how to turn that laser on. Hold on, I didn't even know I had a laser. Oh shit. I didn't know I had a laser. So laser, light, and then laser and light going on. I didn't even know that until like right now. So I have that running, and I have it running on a rail that extends it. So it's an M-lock right here, then that extends out, and then I have a Picatinny on top of that M-lock that extends out. It's kind of jerry-rigged. I kind of did this myself. This little system I got is not something you can just go buy on the internet, but you can buy M-Lock Picatinny extenders. I just had an extra Picatinny slot running around, and I had an extra one of these from another like cheap old Amazon light that I found. And I set this rig up and pushed this light out some, so I didn't want it sitting right here. I wanted it sitting out more in some more space. Then on the other side, you run the wires. You can easily take this handguard off with a simple pin right here. Push that in, you can take the handguard off, ran the wire through it, ran this through it, and my pressure pads on this side. So now I got my hold, however I can hold it just how I want. You know, I can hold it the same exact way, and if I wanna go to turn my light on, all I gotta do is this, which is also another good grip. I can grip it like this, or I can grip it like that. I'm okay either way. So if I'm in a situation where I wanna use my pressure pad, I can do this and I can still have a good grip on the gun. I'm happy with that, and I'm cool with that. This is my grip with the light, this is my grip. Grip with the light, grip without, I'm happy either way. And then also, that's pressure, but you can also turn it on and then move it like that and go back to how you want to go. So I got it set up, you know, how I want. I'm happy. And I love the gun, man. Like I said, it's a little heavy, but it shoots fantastic. 16-inch barrel, 5.56. You can't get any better than that. Ballistic-wise, range-wise, this thing is a monster. And this is a military gun. This is a goddamn gun that's in the military, you feel me? Croatia, I believe, right? And it stands up, man. It stands up to its name, you know? And I'm looking forward to the aftermarket. They fix a trigger, or I've seen different, you know, the ones in Croatia, they have a rail that goes up like this. I want to see all the different type of setups they got going on, because I believe, and correct me if I'm wrong, let me know in the comment section, like my my OGs and stuff, but this is a part of the G36 family, right? I believe that this originally takes the G36 Max, but they fixed it to where it goes and takes the, you know, standard AR. But this, I believe, is like a part of the G36's family in some sort of way. So correct me if I'm wrong. And this is ambidextrous. This is an ambidextrous charging handle, and it is also ambidextrous on the ejection port. So if you're a left-handed shooter, you can set this up where it ejects. You know, if you're a left-handed shooter, you would shoot like this, right? You can set it up to where this doesn't eject out here, it ejects out there, and you could charge on this side. So it's user-friendly as far as that. The safety is also ambidextrous. So it's just it's a great gun overall, man. The price point is definitely up there, but it's a great gun, and I definitely feel like it's a bang for the buck. It comes with a goddamn case. Luckily, you know, some of these guns, you spend like $10,000 and they don't even come in a damn box. This comes with at least a soft case. You got some QD points in there. You got some places to lock up. You know, it's definitely bad to the bone right now, man. I love it. You know, I definitely want it, waiting on a can to come through and go from there. Oh yeah, and last thing too, about the controls, I meant to say. Another weird thing. So release the mag, it's pretty simple. You know, it's like a little latch right there. But to close the bolt, it's called the pitch. So if you're shooting, blah, 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 you run out of ammo, you pick up the new one, you go in there, right? And then you pinch it, and it, that's it. And you go back to work. Another thing I hope that they change or they add on or something is the actual mag flare. I'm just not a big fan of it. I think it's a little too strong. They need this to be flared out a little bit. I need this to be flared. It's too much of a direct, you know, you hit it wrong. I need a flare to go straight in. I just want that. But besides that, man, there's not really much that they knocked out the park. I shot it. I put about, I want to say, 100 or 200 rounds in it. I had a hiccup on that drum mag. But besides that, I don't think I had any issues. This thing was smoking. I even got a little clip of me when I dropped that drum mag. That motherfucker was cooking it. Like all that factory oil was cooking. I gotta clean this thing, read up how to disassemble it, which is not too bad. It's a couple of these pins you take out and go from there, but I want to have more fun with it, and I'm looking forward to having more fun with it. So let me know you guys' thoughts and opinions. This is my current setup. Check out the link down below in the description. I will link you to everything that I did, like the goon tape and all that. I'll link you to all the pieces and parts if you want to grab something that you saw me grab in this video. But Springfield Hellion, which means like bad child or something like that. I forgot the name, what it really means, or a bad little kid or some shit. I don't even know the links for these, but you know, here you go. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that. The AP5. Now it does have a brace. It does have a brace on it, but you got the AP5 fully extended out, you know, brace and all, in the Hellion. I see another one, man. I just gotta see another one. The Ruger 22. It's kind of hard to see. The Ruger 22 is longer, but it does have a brace. I'm gonna take that, like I said. But still, we gotta take that into consideration. Here's my little thoughts and opinions on the Hellion. Let me know you guys' thoughts and opinions down below, and I will furthermore update you guys down the road if I do any adjustments or current setup changes and much, much more. I wanna start even reviewing certain sites. So I might do a review on the AMG. If you wanna see something like that, if you wanna see a review on this, let me know. I love y'all, appreciate y'all, and I'm gonna see y'all on the next one, man. It's your boy, Tony D2 Wild. I'm checking in, I'm checking out. Peace.